Welcome back, everyone. In this video lecture, I will explain to you how to determine the natural frequencies and corresponding natural modes of systems with more than 1 degrees of freedom. The example that I will use for this is this double mass spring system that I've sketched already. What we are going to need for determining natural frequencies and modes is the equation of motion. And the system's equation of motion can be homogeneous, because the natural frequencies do not depend on external excitations. And we can also have the undamped equation of motion, because it also does not depend on damping. Now, using techniques that we have discussed before, we can derive that the equation of motion of this system looks like this. We have a mass matrix times the vector of accelerations, and the stiffness matrix is 2 minus 1 minus 1, 2 times a vector of coordinates x1 and x2, and the right hand side might be 0. All right, the way we are going to solve this set of second order ODEs is basically very similar as what we would have done when we only had one ODE. We are going to try an exponential function, this e to the power st. However, we will account for the fact that we now have two coordinates and that the amplitudes of these coordinates might be different. So I introduce this vector u1 and u2 as unknown amplitudes, and this e to the power st is our usual trial function. So upon substitution in the equation of motion, if we differentiate twice, we get just s squared in front of this expression twice, because u1 and ut do not depend on time. So we get it like this. We get, we get m s squared 1, 0, 0, 1 times u1, u2, e to the power st plus k times 2 minus 1 minus 1, 2 u1, u2, e to the power st is equal to 0, 0. Now, e to the power st is never 0 for finite time, so I will cancel that. And then I will take this u1 and u2 outside of brackets, say. So I will combine this to one big coefficient matrix, one big system matrix that looks like this, ms squared plus 2k. Here we have minus k. This is ms squared plus 2k as well. And here we have minus k. And then we have u1 and u2 equal to 0, 0. Now, if we look at the mathematical form of this equation, we can recognize that this is an eigenvalue problem. In fact, it's called a generalized eigenvalue problem, where s squared, for s squared, where s squared takes the role of eigenvalues. There are two ways in which this can be satisfied. Either the vector u1 and u2 is 0. This is the so-called trivial solution, because if u1 and u2 are 0, then x1 and x2 are 0 as well, so the system is in standstill, not so interesting for vibrations. And the only alternative for this system to work is if the set of equations is linearly dependent. And this would mean that the determinant of this coefficient matrix should be 0. So let's see if we can find values for s for which this can be realized. So the determinant is ms squared plus 2k times ms squared plus 2k minus minus k times minus k. So this is this results in, m squared s to the power 4 plus 4k m s squared plus 3k squared. and that equals 0. So this is a polynomial in S. It's in fact a quadratic equation in terms of S squared. Let me make it slightly more simple by divide by m squared, like this, k over m s squared plus 3k squared divided by m squared is equal to 0. And this is called the characteristic equation. So the process you see is actually fairly similar as what we had for one degree of freedom. Only now we end up with this characteristic equation by demanding the determinant to be zero. So there's like a small step in between. Now, in general, we see here that this is a quadratic equation for s squared. We can solve it using the quadratic formula. But in this case, because the numbers are easy, I can factorize it immediately as follows. Where here we need a k divided by m, and here we need 3k divided by m. That means that there are two solutions for s squared. The first solution is that s squared is minus k over m, and the second solution is that s squared is minus 3k over m. So we see that both solutions are real and negative. That means that the solutions for S can be expressed in terms of purely imaginary numbers, and these are the so-called eigenfrequencies. So I can write them as plus or minus I omega 1 plus or minus I omega 2, where omega 1 is then defined as the square root of k over m, and omega 2 as the square root of 3k over m. So these are the eigenfrequencies or the natural frequencies of the system. Natural frequencies. And we see that we indeed obtain two numbers here. All right. Now, these natural modes, these are expressions for, these are ratios for the coordinates, such that if the system vibrates in its first natural frequency, the coordinates will move in this ratio. And the second mode is a ratio that will be seen when the system vibrates in this second natural frequency. How to obtain it? Well, the way to go is that we substitute the solutions for S squared back into the eigenvalue problem. So let's do that for the first solution. So if S squared is minus k over m, we substitute that in the eigenvalue problem. Then we get, so m S squared is minus k plus 2k, that is k. Here we just have minus k, minus k, k, times u1 and u2. And this is now, let me call this 1. 0, 0. So in fact, these natural frequencies, they relate to the eigenvalues of the eigenvalue problem. And these eigenmodes are the corresponding eigenvectors. And we are now in search for the first eigenvector. So from this expression, you can see that these equations are indeed linearly dependent. The second equation is just minus 1 times the first. This makes sense because we demanded the determinant to be zero. So that's really why we have this dependent set. So we get from it that this should be satisfied like when k times u1 minus k times u2 is zero. Now this works whenever u1 and u2 are the same. So let me denote it like this, that u1 and u2 1 can be some arbitrary scaling times 1, 1. We don't know the exact solution, but at least they should be the same. So this alpha is an arbitrary scaling, and it is natural mode 1. Okay, now let's do something similar for the second natural frequency. We back substitute minus 3k over m into the eigenvalue problem. We get minus 3k plus 2k, that's minus k, minus k, minus k, minus k. So here you can indeed see that these two equations are in fact exactly the same. Equal to 0, 0. So we get that minus k times u1 minus k times u2 should be equal to 0. And this is satisfied whenever u1 and u2 are opposite numbers. Same magnitude, opposite sign. So it should be something like this. Arbitrary scaling times 1 minus 1. And this is then the second natural mode. Natural mode 2. Okay, so I think this demonstrates clearly the procedure. We start with an equation of motion that is homogeneous and undamped. We try the exponential solution for this homogeneous equation. We develop the eigenvalue problem by demanding the determinant to zero. We get the characteristic equation. From that, we solve natural frequencies, and by back substitution, we obtain the natural modes. So I think this clearly demonstrates the procedure. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.